If you've ever bought a projector, you'll recognize the term brightness, or lumens. If you've bought a projector recently, you may have seen a metric called color brightness, or color light output. Now, most people recognize that these numbers refer to how powerful a projector is, essentially how much light the projector can put out. But very few people understand how these numbers are actually calculated. So that's what we're going to look at here today. We're going to look at how one estimates the brightness of a projector, both the brightness of white and the brightness of color. Now, in order to do that, we're going to use a lux meter or a light meter. Now, this is a tool designed specifically to measure the brightness of light.
This one is from a company called Maztec. The model is LX1330B. You can get this from Amazon for about $50. You could pay thousands of dollars for sophisticated test equipment, but we're just going to be making some simple estimates, so this will be fine. If you're buying multiple projectors for work or for a school, a lux meter like this is a good little investment. This meter has 5 buttons. Power is self-explanatory. The button in the upper right selects between 2 different metrics for light, lux and foot candles. For what we're doing, make sure the meter is set to lux. In the next row, you have peak and hold. Hold is simple to understand. When you hit the hold button, the meter will hold its current lux reading. The peak function is similar. Once you press the peak button, the meter will watch for and record the maximum lux reading. The fifth button toggles through the 4 number ranges on this particular meter: hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, and hundred thousands. Which range you need depends on how bright your light source is. If you see a decimal point in the number section, that means you're looking at the hundreds range. Press the range button once and the decimal disappears. Now you're in the thousands range. Hit the range button again and you'll see a little times 10 icon on the bottom of the screen. That's the tens of thousands range. Hit the button again and you'll see a times 100 icon. Now you're in the hundreds of thousands range. If you see a screen with the number 1 to the far left and a decimal point, that means that your light source is too bright for the current number range. Try pressing the range button until numbers are shown again. So we've got our measurement tool. Now we need something to measure. Here's a sample projector from a leading maker. The specification for this projector is 2200 lumens. We want to adjust the height of the projector so that the image on the screen is perfectly square. If you use any digital keystoning, you'll be throwing away some brightness. I've also set the zoom dial to make the image as big as possible. We've got our measurement device and a projector. What are we going to project? I've set up a simple Excel macro that will help guide you through the steps. Here's a link to that file. Note, you may need to go into your security settings in Excel to use the macros. I won't go into those settings here. You can email me or look it up on YouTube. So you have the Excel file open now. You'll see 2 options. We'll look first at the full Monty. This is the option we want to use to measure a single projector. The tool will first go through a brief set of instructions. You'll need to set your laptop to output at 1024 by 768 XGA resolution. You'll want to turn off all the lights and get the room as dark as possible. Once you've reviewed the instructions and pressed the next button, the tool will ask you for the height of your screen. Why do we need the screen size? Well, if you remember, the light meter is measuring lux. The measurement device simply can't measure lumens. To convert from lux to lumens, we start with an average lux measurement and multiply by the area of the screen in square meters. From the height, Excel will calculate the area of your image. Note, I've told Excel to assume a 4x3 screen. If you need to measure a 16x10 WXGA projector, shoot me an email. Then you'll see a white screen with a checkerboard pattern. Why the Brady Bunch pattern? Well, as we'll see when we start taking measurements, the light output is a little different across the screen. To account for these variations, we take 9 measurements and average these. How do you take a reading? Well, you want to place the light sensor flat against your screen or wall, in the center of the circle. Hold the sensor there for a couple seconds and then read the number on the meter. Again, if you see a number 1 on the far left with just a decimal point, that means the light is too bright for that number range. Now you have a number. It's time to type that number into the small box in Excel in the bottom right-hand corner of the square. Make sure you note what range you're in. If your meter reads 248 and the times 10 icon, you're actually reading 2480. Repeat that process for the rest of the 9 squares. This is actually enough to estimate the white brightness or lumens numbers, but we're not quite done yet. Next, we're going to measure the brightness of color. specifically red, green, and blue, the colors that make up the input signal. These measurements will give us the color light output for the projector. Why do we need to measure color? Well, the brightness of white is an important number, but it's only part of the story. When you project, you're probably not just showing black and white. You're probably projecting colorful photos, videos, websites, etc. Since we present in color, we need to measure color. The Excel tool will take you through three screens of color patterns. Simply take and record the 27 light measurements, and Excel will do all the work. So we've recorded all of our lux measurements, it's time to see the results. Excel will shoot out a brightness estimate summary like this. The summary starts with our white brightness estimate. It shows the average of our 9 lux measurements, the screen size in square meters, and an estimate of lumens. Next, the summary will show the average lux readings for red, green, and blue, and an estimate of color light output in lumens. Finally, you'll see a ratio of color to white light. Why is this ratio important? Well, as you start to measure projectors on your own, you'll find that not all projectors create the primary colors equally. In this example, white light output and color light output were equal. This won't always be the case. Here's a second example. This model is rated at 2300 lumens. We'll go through the Excel measurements just like before, but the summary will look very different. Here, white light is estimated at about 2300, but color light output is only 800. Why the difference between color and white brightness? Some projector manufacturers will add white light on top of red, green, and blue to get the maximum white brightness specification. I should point out, when white light output and color light output are not in balance, color performance suffers. The details on this trade-off are outside the scope of this piece, but the short answer is that you should always ask the manufacturer for both the white light output specification as well as the color light output specification. So that's how you can estimate the brightness of white and color for a single projector. What if you just want to quickly compare two projectors side by side? That's where the Battle Royale tool comes in. This macro will take us through 4 screens to quickly capture light output measurements for the two projectors side by side. First, we start with 2 white measurements, entering the lux numbers we measure for both projectors. We repeat this for red, green, and blue. After we take and record the 8 lux measurements, Excel will shoot out a summary. Interestingly, projector B has a slightly higher measurement for white, but color brightness is much darker than projector A. Again, that's why it's necessary that you always ask the manufacturer for brightness data for both white light and color. I hope this short tutorial helps you better understand how lumens are calculated for all front projectors.